atrophy is defined as a decrease in the mass of an organ, firstly in terms of cell volume, and then in the number of cells. But atrophy isn't only a pathological process. In fact, endometrial atrophy occurring during the menstrual cycle or breast atrophy occurring during menopause are two examples of non-pathological processes. Atrophy can be caused by five main factors: disuse, undernutrition, ischemia, compression, and denervation. Disuse atrophy is caused by a reduction in loading on the anatomical structure. The most affected tissue is obviously that of the muscle, since its volume is the first to decrease in case of body immobilization. Atrophy from undernutrition instead can be classified into two forms: marasmus and cachexia. Marasmus is a severe reversal of malnutrition where muscle proteins are converted through glycogenesis into energy. Cachexia, the more severe form, is typical of malignant tumors, where massive production of cytokines as the TNF-alpha may lead to the loss of appetite and consequently to a lipid and protein depletion. Ischemia is then a restriction in blood supply causing a reduction in volume and number of tissue cells. An example is that of age-related cerebral atrophy caused by atherosclerosis. Compression atrophy instead is caused by a specific pressure on a tissue. For example, benign tumors are not harmful themselves since they're benign, but may cause harm since they put pressure on other healthy areas of the body, causing their death. The last one, denervation atrophy, mainly occurs in muscle tissue because its innervation represents a source of survival signals. In fact, signals coming from neuromuscular plaques guide muscle cells' growth and, therefore, severing these structures may lead to the atrophy of the tissue. Peripheral motor neuropathies are an example of this phenomenon. Nerves get sick, sever themselves, and consequently, atrophy develops in the muscle tissue that they innervate. Hormones are, of course, capable of causing atrophy in physiological forms, as we said. From a biological point of view, atrophy is linked to a number of mechanisms: protein synthesis reduction on the one hand, and ubiquitin proteasome system hyperactivity on the other hand. Protein synthesis reduction may be observed in case of a mobilized muscle with a lack in protein synthesis in the sarcomere, while ubiquitin proteasome system is especially stimulated by IL-1-beta and TNF-alpha cytokines. The proteasome plays a key role in the disposal of cellular waste products, but in this case, it works by destroying the physiological proteins of the cell. As for the phenomenon of autophagy, this is strictly related to atrophy, because granules damaged in a tissue with no source of livelihood get destroyed by the cell through lysosomes. Obviously, the remaining pigments will be stockpiled in the tissue as the granules of lipofuscins. Lipofuscins are responsible for the brownish color of the atrophic tissue, and this is why we sometimes talk about brown atrophy. Thank you for watching. This video was created by School of Biomedical Sciences Agora. We hope you enjoyed it. If you're curious or have any doubt or question, please feel free to leave a comment below. If you want to find out more about us or want to support our project, click on the following link to visit our website. Thank you for watching. This video was created by School of